Hello, ladies. As promised, today I'm going to be talking about copper toxicity. So if you are listening to this and you're like, WTF is copper toxicity? And why do I care? And you have anxiety, you're definitely going to want to tune in because this is a huge missing link to anxiety that unfortunately not a lot of practitioners talk about. So this is something that I address in my 12-week program, the Holistic Anxiety Fix. So I talk about minerals, and in particular, if you're doing a hair test as part of this program, I'm also going to be talking about copper and copper toxicity. And it's also something that I offer in my membership program, which I'm going to be opening up at the end of August for one-time only enrollment, which I've never done before and probably won't do again. So stay tuned to learn more about copper toxicity and why it's actually linked with your anxiety. So I know for me, when I first ran my first hair test, I was like, what the heck is copper toxicity and why do I care? I actually sort of thought it was a bit of hogwash. I was super skeptical about it, especially because I hadn't heard of it before. But it turned out for me, copper was a huge piece of my anxiety puzzle. And in fact, my copper was so high that it was driving a lot of my anxiety symptoms. So why would you want to listen into this? So I'm going to go through some of the symptoms of copper toxicity. And let me tell you, there's a lot of symptoms. So I'm just going to touch on some of the main ones. So some of the issues you may have as side issues are thyroid issues, as well as adrenal function issues. But some of the more specific and direct issues can be feelings of nausea. So that racing mind. So a lot of you in this group are telling me, and let me know if you're listening in and I talk about any symptoms, just give me a thumbs up in as you're listening, if these are relating to you. So racing mind, so can't calm the thoughts down at all. So they're going over and over and over. They're looping. You're finding you're stuck on things that maybe aren't necessarily realistic, and yet you can't get your mind off of them. So for me, I was stressed out about writing a blog post before I'd even launched a business. So it really didn't make any sense to me. If you're struggling with panic attacks, if you have heart palpitations, if you fluctuate from that anxiety to depression, if you have hair loss or brain fog, or you find you're irritable, all of these things are associated with copper toxicity, as is increased PMS, headaches, yeast infections, and gut issues. So how exactly does somebody get copper toxicity and why might you have it? So there are a few reasons you might have copper toxicity. And you don't have to work with copper or drink out of copper mugs to get copper toxicity. So one of the main reasons you can get copper toxicity is simply by being estrogen dominant. And so if your hormones are imbalanced, this can actually lead to copper toxicity over time. So when I'm talking about estrogen dominance, what I'm actually looking at is whether your estrogen levels are higher than your progesterone levels. So if this is something that you think you struggle with, or you've been on the birth control pill. And so when I talk to a lot of women, they're not really sure what this means. So this could be IUD or any other form of birth control that's hormonal. Then what actually happens is that this creates a situation where estrogen is higher than your progesterone naturally. And what happens here then is that the body is going to start storing copper in your tissues. So you're going to get this buildup of copper without even having direct exposure to copper. And then what happens is that this copper becomes stored in these tissues. And if the copper gets too high, what can happen is you can start to experience copper dumping. And this is where the copper starts to activate your adrenal glands, which then activates your stress response, which then leaves you with this feeling of racing thoughts or like you cannot calm your body down. So if you're doing all of this work with your mindset through therapy, you know, through relaxation techniques, all of those things are going to be great, but they're not actually going to be able to address the underlying cause of why you're so stimulated in the first place, which in this case, what I'm talking about is internal. It's an internal over accumulation of a mineral that's natural to your body, but now it's in high concentrations. And because of that, it's causing side effects that are leading you to be anxious all the time because it's pushing on your nervous system. So this is probably why medication isn't working for you, or why, you know, the therapy isn't necessarily working for you, because you're not getting to the root cause, which is rebalancing your minerals. Because what can actually happen is that the copper is going to stress your body out so much that now you're going to start burning through those calming minerals. So you're going to burn through the magnesium, you're going to burn through the potassium, and this is what leads to the heart palpitations or the panic attacks or the discomfort. So it's really, really important that you balance your minerals. So a lot of people say to me like, hey, what can I do to balance my minerals? So it's really, really hard for me to give a generic suggestion to balance minerals unless I see your mineral profile. So generically, some of the things that you can do, and I've talked about this before, but is to salt your water. So this is gonna help support your minerals. It's gonna be either to take magnesium or to go into an Epsom salt bath to support your body with electrolytes. So all of those things are going to help with mineral balance, but oftentimes it's not enough to nudge that copper out of the system. And when you're nudging the copper out of the system, what you're actually going to want to do is take a special binder so it escorts that copper out of your body so that it's not continually recirculating. So what I actually do is I run a hair, tissue, and mineral analysis. And this test gives me a much better picture of what is going on with your minerals and how to support your body. So what's interesting with this test is that the results are actually fairly phenomenal for some people. I have had people that have done this test and within 6 days, low blood pressure that's been off for years has completely normalized. I've also had people that have taken these mineral supplements, myself included, where heart palpitations were significantly decreased because we were addressing the root causes of why that's going on. So if you're looking to dive deeper into copper toxicity, to learn more about it, to understand if this is something that you're struggling with, then there are two ways you can do this with me. One is through my Holistic Anxiety Fix program, and this is that comprehensive program where I take you through step by step lots of strategies to address anxiety, including copper, and I'm pulling on the hair because it is a hair test. And the second way is to join my membership, which I'm doing a one-time only opening at the end of August. And through this membership, I'm actually offering a hair test as well. So this is also a very affordable option, and I'm opening this up partially because COVID has just crushed a lot of people's finances. So if you're curious to know more about copper, if you think you're copper toxic, then write in the comments below this video, copper toxic, and I will send you a message with some more information so you can do some more reading. Otherwise, hopefully this has reframed your idea of some of the other root causes that can be underneath your anxiety, copper being one of them. Have a good day.